A $900 budget build with modern components built inside of a brand new PC case in this economy? Well, we made it happen. We're gonna tell you all about it right here, right now on Robeytech. After a word from our sponsor. If you've just built or upgraded your PC and now that Windows watermark just saying activate Windows is just sitting in your face, don't panic. VIP-CDKDeals.com is here to help. VIP-CDKDeals offers legitimate software activation keys at a fraction of the retail price. We're talking deep discounts on Windows 10 and 11, home and pro versions, plus Microsoft Office, Steam keys, and so much more. You can even use code RBCK at checkout for an additional 30% off. Check out VIP-CDKDeals.com today and get back to enjoying your PC without that watermark. It has been the hottest of minutes since we've done a budget build here on our channel, but it would be an understatement to say that the prices and availability have been all over the map this year. Fortunately, things seem to be evening out, and I say fortunate because when we were at Computex this summer, we saw a PC case that reignited our dream of showing off the possibilities of low dollar options. We're gonna be using our 5-point weight system to show how this budget build is balanced within the following categories. Price, or how well did we actually use our budget, CPU power, GPU power, parts and features, things like RGB, CPU cooler, RAM speed, and SSD performance, and finally, aesthetics. And remember, this video is only part of the story. Now you can watch the live stream where we build the system for all of the close-up shots, explanations of what we're doing and why, and learn how you can build a PC like this for yourself. And you can check that out over at Robeytech Live. Also, make sure you like and subscribe and ring the notification bells both on Robeytech and Robeytech Live so you don't miss our next budget build stream. All right, let's talk about this build, how we landed on the price, and the target we aim for. Like I said in the intro, it started with the case, the $60 Phanteks Eclipse G370A, which we actually have our full review of right here. Then what was happening is we were doing a pre-built PC that we found for around $900 that featured a modern-ish Ryzen 5 paired with an RTX 5060. During our testing of that machine, we picked up a matching CPU and GPU to do some extra experimenting with. And as we were testing, we started asking ourselves if we could take these core components and whether they would match or beat what we were seeing from the pre-built system, which you can see the overview of right here. What we discovered is that at our core, what we had is a killer combo for 1080p gaming and something we could totally build off of. With that context and a goal in mind, let's talk about the parts and see where they land within our five categories. Starting with our CPU and motherboard, we're using the AMD Ryzen 5 8400F. This was a bit of a different choice here because it's not a common CPU, but the Ryzen 5 8400F shares some similarity with the Ryzen 5s we know and love. It's still a 6-core, 12-thread CPU on the AM5 platform and still has a default TDP of 65 watts. But this lower cost option has a slightly lower clock speed and no integrated GPU. While this is a baseline option for a CPU, the AM5 platform has incredible verticality to it in terms of how you can actually upgrade within it. As for the motherboard, we're using the ASRock B650 PG Lightning motherboard. This is an older board, but it does give us a reinforced PCIe 4 lane for our GPU, as well as one PCIe 5 M.2 slot and two PCIe 4 M.2 slots, although one of those Gen 4 slots only has two bus lanes, not four. It's also worth noting that this board does not have any Wi-Fi. So we're using a pretty lean board here, but that's part of the build's charm. It's scrappy. For our parts and feature score, since we're using an older and more limited motherboard, our parts and feature score is going to start on the lower side of the middle for now. For our CPU, we're going to score it around the same place. It's not a bad CPU, but it is the doorman for the modern Ryzen stack. As for CPU cooling, we don't need much here, but we still want our CPU to have some good thermal headroom. To fit this need, we're using the Thermalright Assassin X120 Refined SC Air Cooler. This thing has a thin heat sink, a single 120mm fan, and a price under $18, so lots to love here. Now, in case you're wondering why we didn't use the stock AMD cooler and save some money there, the 8400F was kind of a bring-your-own CPU heat sink kind of CPU. So, kind of here we are. We aren't going to knock the price score here because buying the 8400F with the Assassin X was still cheaper than buying a 7600 non-X with one. Now moving on to RAM, we're using the Crucial 32GB Pro Overclocking Kit. This thing is rated at 6,000 megatransfers with a cast latency of 36. This is low profile, non-RGB RAM, which does help fit with the simplified theme of this build. Since it does have Expo profiles for AMD, we're gonna leave the parts and features where it is. As for aesthetics, we're gonna call it understated and move on to our GPU. For our GPU, we're using PNY's GeForce RTX 5060 ARGB Epix-X Edition. This GPU not only gives us access to NVIDIA's latest GPU technology with things like DLSS4 and DLSS multi-frame generation, it also has some RGB on it, so there's a win. Now, I know this is a contentious GPU because this has lower VRAM than the Intel Arc B580 or the 16GB AMD Radeon 9060 XT, so we're gonna put our GPU power score kinda in the middle. Now moving on to storage, we're using the 1 TB Kingston NV3 NVMe drive. We really like these drives for their faster read and write speeds than most entry-level PCIe 4 drives, and it only costs around $60. Now, could we have gone with a 2 TB drive? Probably, but we would have added another $60 to our budget, and we're staying under $1,000, dang it. So, for scoring here, we're gonna bump up parts and features and price scores since this is a fast drive at a fantastic price. As for our case, we're using the newcomer to the budget build scene, the Phanteks Eclipse G370A. This case only costs $60 and it comes with 320mm Phanteks M25 Gen 1 ARGB fans. It's also worth noting that the USB port up top only uses an internal USB 3.0 connection, so even the USB-C port is a slow USB 3 connection. We should also point out that we added a non-RGB M25 fan in the back, which added another $8-ish to the overall price, so parts and features is a mixed bag on this one. On one hand, if you do want to add an exhaust fan, it's going to cost you, but it's a $60 case that we've actually seen on sale for $50 already. It's easy to build inside of, and you'll see here in a minute, it's actually a solid performer too. And finally, for PSU, we have another newcomer to our budget build series, the 2025 Corsair RM750E 750-watt gold PSU. Corsair's latest design of their RM line includes easily manageable cables that rival the Asus Tough Gaming PSUs that we've seen on other Robeytech Live episodes and even in our budget builds, and it has cable cones. And with that price, that's a bit more competitive, we had to include it in this build. This PSU, it does offer some extra headroom for future growth. It's also got a 12-volt, 16-pin GPU cable in case you wanted to upgrade to a more powerful GPU down the road. And again, it comes with some really, really nice cables with cable combs. When we put all this together, the total cost before taxes and shipping comes in at around $920. So if you're gonna score it in our five categories, here's where it would land. CPU power lands in the lower middle, GPU power lands in the middle, parts and features also lands in the middle. As for aesthetics, this may be a no-frills build, but it's not ugly. I'd call it an Idaho 10, kind of mid, but pretty in some settings. And finally, for our budget score, we stayed under $1,000, so I'd give this one some nice solid marks. So lots of mid marks, but let's see if performance can make up for all of the mid here. All right, diving into native 1080p performance, most of our games average over 100 frames per second, with only Cyberpunk 2077 and Doom the Dark Ages lagging ever so slightly under. Keep in mind that we were testing these titles at some of their highest presets, with the exception of Marvel Rivals, Fortnite, and one of the sets of Call of Duty data. For these three, we turned down the details to maximize frame rates like you would in competitive gaming. Now, we also stepped Forza down from extreme to high, not because it couldn't hang, but because we were seeing it hit some of the GPU VRAM limits when we added things like DLSS and multi-frame generation, and we wanted to show an accurate comparison across all settings. What's wild though, and we have to call this out, at native settings with no upscaling or frame gen magic, Cyberpunk is still pulling an average of around 93 frames per second, and that's with ray tracing on low. If you've ever played around with this game, that's still a high level of texture detail going on, plus some moderate ray tracing goodness. When we add in DLSS, everyone is in the over 100 FPS average club. While we don't see much of an improvement with DLSS under COD's multiplayer settings or with adding DLSS to Fortnite, we do see some marked improvements. Since we saw above 60 averages in our performance in our native tests, we had to add in frame generation and multi-frame generation just to see what we could see. In most of our titles, we saw averages north of 200 FPS. And again, the experience from those is gonna be absolutely great given the high native FPS rating that we got. Again, I know that there's some mixed feelings around multi-frame gen and the RTX 5060 out on the internet, but if it isn't your jam, that's completely okay. You can actually check out our whole video on it right here. Now we're gonna throw some of our productivity and creative application scores up on the screen too, because if you're someone looking to do multiple things with your PC, I'm not sure what more you could want for from this price point. So with solid game performance for the price, how did our case and air cooler handle temps? Overall, pretty decent. Our 8400F averaged around 82 degrees Celsius under full CPU load and around 56 degrees while gaming. As for the RTX 5060, it averaged around 54 degrees Celsius while gaming. Keep in mind, these are box to build numbers. We could spend some time tweaking them, but the Assassin X120 refined SE cooler and the Eclipse G370A case provided a solid amount of air to keep our components away from the danger zone. As we start wrapping this one up, just a reminder that you can find all of our budget builds, parts lists, performance, and the live stream videos over at robeytech.com. And if you have other components you want to try in this build, go ahead and be our guest. At the end of the day, what we love about this PC is that it's a great launching point into PC gaming that won't break the bank. comparatively. Obviously, the $900 price point assumes that you can get these components at the listed price. That being said, the markets have been normalizing, especially on GPU pricing and availability. And who knows, by the time you watch this video, maybe the prices of Ryzen 9000 will come down enough to make more sense for a build like this. And with that, we'll close out this rundown of our Robeytech Return to Budget Build Glory PC featuring the AMD Ryzen 5 8400F and the NVIDIA RTX 5060. And as always, please let us know if you built one yourself by joining the Robeytech Discord. This is also a great place to ask any questions you may have along the way over at discord.gg/Robeytech. If this configuration doesn't quite match what you're looking for, we have more on the website and more coming soon. We'll be building these systems live over at twitch.tv/Robeytech or over at youtube.com/Robeytech Live, and we'll have breakdown videos like this one right here on our main youtube.com/Robeytech channel. So slap the subscribe button with that like button and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech or over at Robeytech Live. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.